And here is the Writer's Almanac for Friday, October the 9th, 2020. It's the birthday of Jill Kerr Conway, born in New South Wales, Australia, 1934. Father was a sheep rancher. She grew up in isolation on a sheep ranch, far, far from town. She became a sheep hand on the ranch, checking fences and prodding sheep from one paddock to another. Went off to college, studied history, and then spent 10 years as the president of Smith College, first woman to hold that position. She's the author of The Road from Kurrain and A Woman's Education. Jill Kerr Conway, who said, "You never know what you'll want to write until it starts writing itself in your head." It's the birthday of Belva Plaine, born Belva Offenberg, New York City, 1915, graduated from Barnard, degree in history. She wrote multi-generational family sagas of Jewish immigrants. And though the critics were not always kind to Belva Plaine's books, one of them called the books easy, consoling works of generous spirit, fat with plot and sentiment, thin in nearly every other way, and almost invisible in character development. Nonetheless, readers loved them, and they were all bestsellers. Her first book, Evergreen, published in 1978, was made into a miniseries in 1985. It was a big bestseller. She wrote longhand in spiral notebooks, and she produced a novel about every year or so. It's the birthday of John Lennon, born Liverpool, England, 1940, during a German air raid. His mother, Julia Stanley, was a free spirit, married a sailor named Freddie Lennon on a whim. Freddie managed to be gone most of the time, and Julia gave the little boy to her sister Mimi to raise. He didn't show much musical inclination as a child, but he did love drawing and reading. He loved Lewis Carroll's Alice's Adventures in Wonderland and The Wind in the Willows and the Just William stories by Richard Crompton. He was bright, often in trouble in school, and when Elvis Presley came on the scene in 1956, it became the focus of the boy's life. When he was 17, John Lennon formed his own band, the Quarrymen, and soon after that, Paul McCartney and then George Harrison joined. And by 1960, they were calling themselves the Beatles. It's the birthday of the Irish poet Ciarán Carson, 1948, in Belfast. His parents only spoke Irish at home, and the Carson children learned English playing in the streets with other children. Author of many books, including Belfast Confetti and Shamrock Tea. Ciarán Carson, who said there's a whole language out there, and one's role as a writer is to stumble around in it. And it's the birthday of the composer Camille Saint-Saëns, born in Paris, 1835. Wrote 13 operas, of which the most famous, really the only one much performed, was Samson and Delilah. Toured frequently, playing his piano concertos all over Europe and the United States, accompanied by a servant and his pet dogs. Saint-Saëns, who said, "I like good company, but I like hard work even better." Here's a poem for today by Hilaire Belloc, The Yak. "As a friend to the children, commend me the yak. You will find it exactly the thing. It will carry and fetch. You can ride on its back or lead it about with a string. The Tartar who dwells on the plains of Tibet, a desolate region of snow, has for centuries made it a nursery pet, and surely the Tartar should know. Then tell your papa where the yak can be got, and if he is awfully rich, he will buy you the creature, or else he will not. I cannot be positive which." The Yak by Hilaire Belloc. That's the Writer's Almanac for Friday, October the 9th. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.